welcome everybody.
So a special interview. A lot of people can't be able to sit with this man. Very busy man. You already probably recognize him by the hoodie. If you haven't got your video recorded by this man, then you didn't get a real video yet. If he ain't behind your camera, you ain't got the right cameraman. I'm talking about Chop Mosley. Right now, I got somehow, some way, the PNB Rock little baby version playing right now. The reason why I got PNB Rock playing is I feel like both of y'all was very inspirational in the city of Philly with a certain song. And I was about to play that next. That's My City Needs Something. But you did say that the city still needs something.
Yeah, for sure.
What is it that the city need? Like,
we need these younger kids to really, like, they don't have anybody to look up to. They don't have anybody to reach. They don't have anybody to touch. They actually gotten themselves through life. You know what I'm saying? And it kind of, it's hurting them. It's like, they don't have my generation, we had
older guys. You know, right. So we looked up to people like, oh, they doing it the right way. And so they don't have that.
They don't have the OGs no more.
And the street game is a lot different. And so they don't have the code of ethics and the principles and morals. It's gone. That's the main thing. They need guidance, man. That's some of the problem.
So, I'm gonna let the song play right now. And every time I turn around, yeah, got into the thing. It's kind of funny though. I asked my little brother, he's like 15, so he just started high school. I asked him, do you know who Chop Mosley is? He said, no. I said, you know, I found out about music videos because of Chop Mosley. High school, 2013, I was a senior. Fall in love with PNB Rock, not understanding that you was the man that got it to me, because he probably made them songs. I probably never would have listened to the song without you making that visual. And even with that visual, it's like when I first heard it, you touched somebody's heart, like, because everybody go through that same pain in Philly. It's like we don't want to see the next person do better than us, but we do know that at some point, we do want to see somebody do better for the city. And I feel like we got to go more to that, as we want the whole city to be on. Like, us against the world, kind of. That makes sense.
Yeah, it's going to happen. It's just going to take a lot of time. A lot of these people want to be, you know, like, the man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And not embrace. My whole thing, even with Filmmob, when I started Filmmob, I wasn't really thinking about myself. It just so happened I became the popular face of the group.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But it was a group of us. You know what I'm saying? And that meant something to me. You know what I'm saying? It didn't go as planned, but my overall thing is like,
I was going to go into that, but
we'll
I see the vision. I mean, yeah. It's like heat makers. It's like, it's a group of talent that when y'all come together.
Sure. Yeah, it just didn't work because I just felt like people was in competition with each other. You know what I'm saying? It couldn't work that way.
That's what I mean by that. In Philly, it's like the feel of you don't want to see the person next to you do better, and it's like,
and you should.
Yeah, you should.
You
yeah,
should want to though.
I mean, like, I encourage anybody coming around me, man. I want them to see. I don't care if you pass me
exactly
1,000 times. Cool. I really don't care. You know,
I should be.
That made me feel good to know that you came around me. You successful. That means I played a good part. Played a part in you being successful.
And it takes a village for real.
Yeah, it does.
And a lot of people don't understand. Like, you know, just seeing you, the next generation, even though y'all not my next generation, y'all like 2 generations removed, but y'all are my next generation because I love to see the young boys. Y'all doing well. You know, I look at y'all group, you know, it's a selective few, and I look at, like, the boys even playing football. Their little crew is a crew. You know what I mean? Just like you have your little crew. But it's just amazing to see to see you guys. It does my heart well, because now, you know, like I say, well, you know, people, we die quick.
Yeah, yeah.
And just to see that, knowing that y'all are, there's a group of y'all taking care of each other, I can rest at night. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So that's important that y'all carry this torch.
Yeah. I don't know if people tuned in, but if you looking to do anything, business or entertainment, anything, just go look at Kevin Hart documentary.
He actually
shows you what a team is supposed to be, man.
A strong team.
Yeah, and then they had me rethinking, like, I was doing it all wrong the first time. You know what I'm saying? So now that I know, I'm going to rebuild stronger.
Oh, yeah, but your blueprint. You have a good blueprint.
Yeah, for sure.
You do. And it's important, like, people don't realize you meet people and various people in your life for a reason. Yeah. And everybody's supposed to just put that piece together. You know, them pieces. Like, I look at some of your work, and I've been following your work just because you're my young G, I'll put it that way. Just looking at your work, even what you did with Dre's video was beautiful. It was a piece of art, and you showed the city in a different light. Yeah. You know, even little videos you put on Instagram, you know what I mean? His moves and plays. The vision that you have is incredible. So don't lose focus. Even coming to see the first part of the trap. Dude, that movie was Netflix. Y'all need to sign this man. One of y'all need to do something big, because you really do have a vision. And I'm proud of that.
This is crazy, man, because it's like, I didn't really even get the whole city behind it yet. You know what I'm saying? And that's the crazy part.
For sure.
That's the crazy part. And it did well. You know what I'm saying? A lot of the viewers not even from Philly.
You know what the crazy part is? And these young people don't understand. If you look at your Instagram and you have, say, 95K or whatever number you have, if each one of these people reposts your video, a video that you put up or a clip, do you know what that feed could do?
Yeah. It'll put it in a whole different light. You know.
And that's what everybody needs to do.
But you saying it, not that easy.
No, it's not.
And it's like with Philly, you got to do it outside before the Philly even recognized it.
I mean, it's sad to admit that, you know what I'm saying? I was always in denial about that. I always was like, man, Philly going to come around.
Wow. But it's...
You definitely got to make noise somewhere else before the whole city get behind you. You know what I'm saying? That's sad.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
But the point about you, like, having a team and it not working the first time, I had that kind of same struggle like a year and a half ago trying to build, like, a podcast kind of team. Mm-hmm. I had, like, 5-6 people and it's hard to move. Had moving like parties all around and all be on that one accord. Had that one goal in mindset.
It takes a special group of people to be a successful team, man. It's just.
Yeah. And I was going to ask you, what do you see now that you didn't see back then, though?
I really was just trying to, like, I was going off of talent. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I had guys around me that were super talented. So, but we just didn't mesh well.
Okay.
Together, you know, so we all had different mindsets. We had different agendas. So now I'm bringing in talents and people, but I'm actually also getting to know them on a more personal level. You know what I'm saying? So I want to have the same morals and values as you. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to have to, when I go to sleep right now, I don't have to question, like, yo, is he on some weird shit? Or, you know what I'm saying? Can you curse on this, y'all?
Yeah.
Is he on some weird shit? Or, you know what I mean? But at this point, I just take my time and really get to know people before I actually invite them in.
And you gotta keep your circle tight.
By
any chance, do you use, like, your film classes or your classes basically to choose some of your new employees or no?
Not employees, but team members.
Sometimes.
Well, Quay actually reached out to me via email, right, Quay? Yeah, she is a she wanted to intern and stuff like that. So she's been around for a few months now.
Okay. That's good.
How long you say you've been around? It's almost 6-7 months now.
Okay. Hang in there, sweetie.
We've been rocking and rolling.
You know what I mean? Just hang in there.
Like, it's just like she knew, but I treat her like much my little sister. You
right.
know what I'm saying? So, like, at the end of the day, it really don't matter how you find the people. It's just finding the right people. You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm at with it now. Like, I'm just trying to find the right people. You know what I'm saying? And we all can't do the same job.
No.
So you got to find different people to fill different voids. Yeah. So I don't want to be the best person in the room because I don't have a good team if I'm the best person in the room.
Exactly.
So that's how I look at it now.
And I hope all you young people listen to what he said because that's real.
You got to change your mindset.
Yeah. I can't be the best director, the best shooter. I don't want to be the best shooter, director, and editor. I want to be the best director I can be. I want to work with the best cinematographer, the best editors. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to have to do everything. Because when you wear so many hats, you spread yourself thin. So I'm just trying not to do that, you know what I'm saying, at this point in my career.
But you are wearing a couple hats when you go from music videos
to
film.
Yeah, yeah.
But
I mean,
I feel like that blueprint was already made for you. You got to follow that for the city of Philly.
Yeah, but for film, that was always the end goal. Okay. You know what I'm saying? I just had to get comfortable enough to express myself in that way. You know what I'm saying? So music video, if you look at my music videos, they shot in a film format. It just don't have the audio behind it because of the music.
That's what sets you apart from...
Yeah, yeah. I told stories, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Even though...
Visual stories.
People said my stuff looked the same. Nah, that's just my style. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to look like everybody else. I don't want to have 1,000 emojis and stuff popping up. I don't want to do that. Yeah. That's not my style. You know what I'm saying? You go to them for that. When you want something cinematic, you come to me.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? So I think everybody had their own styles, and you know, I just embrace mine.
Sure. But my pop did mention the Dre highlight reel, but my pop probably don't know that you was probably the first highlight reel you made.
Yeah, I actually...
Football and basketball.
Yeah, Dre actually is the first person sports-wise that I actually connected with. I always used to send people to A-Dive. That's my A-Dive mind. That's like me and him started together. Like,
okay.
So we went to Lutheran together. We played ball. And then he was in school down North Carolina. Shaw. He went to Shaw. Shaw, North Carolina, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he was at Shaw. He came home. He was like, yo... I want to start this. I was like, yeah, I want to do the music video. He's like, and we just started rocking. He's like, we gonna be the best in the city. We had that talk, and it happened.
And it happened.
Yeah, yeah. But
see, we had that conversation earlier. If you write down your goals, write down different things, they will come to pass.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? I was accomplishing goals and I didn't even know I accomplished them. it's only one goal left for me right now, and that was to become a millionaire on film.
And that's coming.
Yeah, so
I see it's coming.
Everything else, I pretty much did. I got subscribers on YouTube. I got a series out. I put a movie out. I actually just finished my first feature film. You know what I'm saying? So it's like stuff is happening. You know what I'm saying? It's just like
I was gonna ask you about that movie, The Quiet, right?
Oh, Quiet is that's a short film. That's on YouTube now. Yeah, yeah. Okay, the new film called The Come Up.
Come Up. Okay, yeah. Can you like give us a little spoiler alert, or
It's about a young kid on the music scene trying to come up. You know what I mean? He go through the trials and tribulations, life, friends, baby mom drama,
life.
His homies, like it just happened. You know what I'm saying? And he basically, you know, he make it through all that, and then at the end, you know, he blossomed.
And that's supposed to be based out of Philly.
Yeah, yeah, it's a based in Philly movie. It should be coming out very soon. I'm gonna say springtime.
Springtime.
Are you gonna have another thing like you did last time?
Being as though this, I got hired to do it.
Okay.
I'm not in control of that.
Okay.
Anymore, you know what I'm saying? So it's like I just directed it. So it's their movie.
Never a bad thing just getting hired, right? Getting paid.
Yeah, for sure. Good job, sure, man.
Especially getting paid to do what you love. You know what I mean?
Take a head off of me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure. But Trap season 2.
Yeah.
I just seen you dropped the trailer.
Yeah.
So when
what you think?
It's pretty intense. It's pretty in depth, it's but real.
Yeah, it's getting crazy.
Yeah.
Another thing with Trap, man, I just didn't want these young kids to really get the wrong impression. Like, I'm not glorifying the streets.
No.
I'm trying to show y'all what it looks like firsthand before y'all have to jump out here and try to do it yourself. You know what I'm saying?
In a sneakiness.
Yeah, it's like I'm trying to stay away from it. It ain't what you think it is.
Yeah.
And it ain't for everybody.
No, it's not.
That's what I mean by in depth. It's going to give you the
real. It's not going to give you the glitz and glamour power or having a million kilos like Snowfall. Like, nah, you're going to see the real.
The struggle. People don't understand that.
Yeah.
Trust me. It's a different side to all that.
Yeah, and then I also was given the outsiders a view of like people not from the city, like just not from Philly or not from the inner city. They don't really know what our life looked like. You know what I'm saying? So like this is a great way for them to get acquainted with it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely people. So I went to Morgan down Baltimore. Okay. People was definitely watching Trap. Yeah.
That's what I said. It's so crazy that really the viewers does not. It's like it's some from Philly. Majority of it is out of town.
They love to hear that slang. They love their
it's crazy.
Kid and all that.
It's crazy, man.
And it was really trippy for me because I used to work at Pickett when it was Pickett.
When I
seen some of the scenes, I was like, damn, I remember I had to clean in the locker room.
Limited resources. I'm gonna be honest. It'd be scary if I really got everything I needed to shoot the movie.
I know.
Being serious, it'd be scary. Like I'm telling you, it'd be bad.
You know, what I'm saying? But it's
really,
coming.
We really made something out of nothing.
You did
with the series. You know? So it was like, shout out to Miss Hart though. Miss Hart was a angel. She looked out for me and made that happen. You know, Miss Hart.
Yeah.
It's Chris.
So if anybody listening, they wanted to be on the upcoming season.
It's over.
Or even just work with you.
It's over. Locked in already.
Oh man, then.
No. I'll be having casting calls though. Periodically I have them. So just follow me. Follow
Instagram.
Film Mob, send them a page. That's where a lot of the information is posted. But yeah. They want to. They if you good. I'm going to use you.
For sure.
Right? So
now let's say you had like a story that you didn't know how to like bring the vision, but you had a story.
No, I wouldn't. It got to be on paper.
Cause
you know why, man? Because it's like I'm a writer as well.
All right, so I say somebody had a script.
If it's good, we can sit down and talk. Okay. I might buy it off you.
Might buy it.
Yeah. if it's right, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But it gotta be right. It gotta be already written in the right format, the right.
It gotta be original. Right.
It gotta be right. Yeah, it gotta be right. It can't be.
That's one of the hardest things.
Yeah.
Putting your mind on paper.
Yeah. I mean, it takes a special person to sit there and write a movie. You know what I'm saying? I learned that firsthand.
Especially writing the different parts. Like,
I might be wrong, but I be thinking I had that mindset. So I want you to tell me if I'm wrong. If you think that you have a clear vision of scene by scene, how you want it to play out.
You always have a clear vision of that, but that don't mean that's how it's going to be when you start shooting.
Okay. So
never going to be that way.
Never?
Nah, not even close.
Okay.
I want to tell you, like, as a filmmaker, bro, you probably 60% of it is probably the most you're gonna get of what you were trying to portray, because of all the stuff you're going through on set and everything. It's just, especially for independent, like for you got big budgets and that stuff.
Yeah.
That's why independent wise.
So many movies. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
Yeah, it's hard. It's I don't want people to think it's easy. It's really hard.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? People rushing and have some real weird trap. Like this stuff take time. You know what I'm saying? Like we had one of our castmates, our stars, actually get incarcerated. Free Papers. Shout out Free Poop, man. That's my guy.
Huh?
Yeah. That's so we hurried up and shot some of his scenes, but we didn't really get to do all of them. So I had to sit back and then rewrite the whole story. Yeah, so it was like a lot of stuff I had to take out because of what happened. You know what I'm saying? Then somebody quit. Yeah, so we had to cut out them scenes. It was just a lot, man. And
a lot to do with.
Yeah, and then people wasn't answering the phone, and it was just a lot, man.
See, people don't understand the side note of all that is, if y'all listening, like he's saying, like people got incarcerated or anything, but you want people to invest in you, and you're still out halfway in the street.
No, I wouldn't.
I'm just saying some people.
I wouldn't. I'm not going to speak on his situation.
Not him. I'm not talking about him. I'm talking about in general.
Okay,
they want to be in a situation. They want to do movies or they want to be an artist.
It's hard for
a person to put in something if you're not giving it your all.
Yeah, like I understand you got a job and all that, but like we all sacrificing time. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of my castmates ain't understand that. You know what I'm saying? Just because I don't have a traditional 9-to-5, but I'm sacrificing money being with y'all. Like if I don't work, I don't get paid.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm not working when I'm shooting with y'all. I'm out here just, you know,
investing in
my time, which is more valuable than money. You know what I'm saying? So
that
was a trial and tribulation of trap that I experienced, because I actually expanded the cast from 25 to 175.
Wow.
There's a lot of people in season 2. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, it was crazy. It was
dealing with all them different personalities and stuff too.
I just start building characters and.
Yeah. Wait till y'all see it though. You're going to see exactly, you know what I'm saying, what I was trying to do.
Oh, wow. I can't wait now.
No dates.
I got like
two things in the work right now as far as like the aftermath of finishing it. So I'm trying to weigh my.
Are you going
to
do a big thing like you did last time for that one?
I have to see what they say because I got like a little deal on the table.
Man, I enjoyed the first one, part. I enjoyed that night. Yeah. That was nice.
Fun.
That was really
fun.
Nice.
Yeah, it was fun.
You know what I mean? And you had a lot of support, and I love that.
Yeah, we sold out.
Yeah.
So I ain't gonna lie, man. When people started laughing and stuff, I shed a tear a little bit, man.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, because that was my first time actually seeing people watch my work.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like literally, I wrote it. and I filmed it and I edited it. So I'm like,
you did it all.
Yeah,
you
know, so it was
Tyler Perry.
It was like a baby.
Yeah. It was like, because the other premiere we had, I just shot it. I didn't really, you know, just do everything with it. I wanted to, but this one was like, I was like, wow. Like, you know what I'm saying? People really enjoyed my stuff.
Yeah. So and your brother became a star.
He think he is a star. But, no, but after that, man, I was like, wow, I really can do it. You know what I'm saying? And that kind of motivated me to even do it.
You're talented.
Appreciate it.
Talented, man.
So, I see that you talk to a lot of people. So what's next for you, though? moving West Coast, something?
Nah, man. I'm gonna stay over here. The ultimate goal is, I've been saying this before Tyler Perry did it, but I want to put a big film studio in Philly.
I can see it built.
You know what I'm saying? That was always a goal of mine. A big FM.
Near Butler Street, all them
warehouses.
Houses, yeah. Yeah. Old Kelly's Corner and all back there. Yeah.
You can
do it. I really want to gear towards, like, even though I would let mainstream people use it, but, like, I want independent people to have a place to come express their visions and stuff like that.
So, yeah.
That's definitely the goal in the near future.
Yeah, for sure. And when you do that, you got to do a show.
And a movie deal, man. Movie deal, that's what I'm working for. I want a movie deal.
Like a motion picture.
I want to write, produce, and direct my own films.
Well, shout out to Overbrook, man. Will Smith. Yeah, man. I feel like if anybody can make it happen, probably Will can.
Yeah, they doing Bad Boys was crazy too, man.
I heard they doing the Meek movie too.
Oh, they did do the Meek movie. Yeah, the Light movie.
Yeah,
that's gonna be good too.
Yeah, look real good. Look real good, man. So, shout out to them. We went back to we was talking about Dre, but yeah. So Dre reached out to me, Swift, during it was like his sophomore or junior year. He DM'd me like, "Yo, bro, won't you come check out one of my games and film for me?" And I was like, "All right, I'm gonna get to you." And then he got hurt. So we kept in contact with his junior. He got hurt. I think he hurt his ankle.
Yeah.
So he didn't play that much. So the game I went to, he didn't play. So senior year started, and he's like, "Yo, you ready?" And I'm gonna put on a show. And sure enough, every game I came to, he's
graceful
too, man.
He's
special, man.
When he gets that open, that one little hole,
he's
graceful, man.
And not even just football, man. I connected with him on a personal level. He's like, he's a real good, genuine kid.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I like that about him.
And if y'all don't know, you know, Chop like to play basketball too.
Yeah.
They be having some real wars out there.
He still can't beat me in ball.
No, I mean, y'all had some real wars at the trunk party.
Yeah. You seen him take them out. Like,
yeah, yeah.
You're on wax. Tell him what happened.
I can't tell it all. I'm gonna leave that for you.
No, tell him what happened.
They was talking smack. They was like, "Oh, you can't play," and all that.
What happened?
Old head put on his little Jordans and put his little thing down on him. You know, because you're there, old head. So, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I just
But
try
you
to
did.
A,
you was muscling him, too.
I just try to be a positive voice for him and stuff like that, man. So,
you doing his draft workout? Film?
Yeah, I'm actually supposed to fly down there on Friday to get a few shots.
Yo, make sure you follow me, man. You got to keep posting on everything that you're doing.
Yeah. What else you got from me over there?
I don't know. I was going to ask you about, like, what was your inspiration when starting directing? Like,
I really didn't have one.
Just got a camera?
So, I didn't even know I had this talent, to be honest with you. I was working a dead-end job. I was working for Quest Diagnostics.
Okay.
Overnight joint.
A blood joint.
Yeah, man. Staying up 8 hours in the middle of the night pouring urine and blood. So I didn't really have it. I didn't have, you know what I'm saying, the inspiration to do this until my uncle had passed away. My uncle Steve, rest in peace, Uncle Steve. His close friend was Benny Boone.
Okay.
So my mom told me to reach out and tell Benny that Steve passed away, and I did that. I didn't really know who he was because, you know, I wasn't really into.
Right.
But when he came to Philly, he invited me to Meek, I'm a Boss video shoot.
Mm.
And after that,
change your life.
Yeah.
And it was funny because I remember I'm a Boss video. I know. So Benny Boone did it?
Because Sherman was talking about you too.
Right.
Myers.
Right
here. He was just saying, you know, you were talking about how good you do videos. Because I was laughing when Yayo asked to use my car for the video. And then you came to shoot it. I was like, damn, it's a small world,
yeah,
dog.
Yeah. It's definitely a small world.
You know what I mean? And then just look at homie in the Hellcat. Like, just think, you shot him before he even had to come up.
Yeah. No, I think he was on.
He was on his way up. I'm saying when you did that.
I shot Rican Boy. That was Rican Boy video, but he was there. But no, he definitely was. He was carrying it then too.
Yeah.
With the Film Mob hoodies, where can we buy them at?
You can just reach out to me, man. I'm personal. Yeah.
Hand in hand.
Hand in hand, I ship them to you. I mail them to you.
Okay.
If I'm in the city, I pull up on you. Whatever you want to do, I got you.
Dang, I just had this point that I wanted to ask you. Damn.
Don't forget now.
Yeah, because I'm gonna be mad as hell if I forget now. Come on, quick, my side guy.
I don't know what you was thinking that time.
Nah, anything. I gotta get it back real quick. Dang. All right, whatever.
Well, you got your list.
I'll come back to you.
No, it wasn't on my list. It was something he was rambling, and I had to I wanted to feedback off what he said.
What was it about?
About the videos?
Yeah, about directing. Because, I lost it.
I hope you find it.
What about directing? What you want to know about it?
No, not really about just knowing about directing. Basically, just from that Benny the Boom situation. I'm a boss video, because I remember watching that video. You just purchased the camera or you asked?
I was still part-time in school at this time too, so I had a refund check. I did the grant, John, and then I got the loan. So I was sitting on $5,000-$6,000. So I was like,
I had one of those semesters?
Yeah, and I was just
make it work for you.
I'm gonna buy a camera. I bought a T3i and I bought a laptop. Yeah, I got the lenses and stuff. So at the day, I just started practicing,
and it just came together, huh?
Yeah, because it was switching over from the era of you having this have this big production to people running around with DSLRs.
Right,
you know what I'm saying. So I actually caught that wave
at the right time. In.
Yeah,
and I guess you didn't finish school, or you did?
No, I didn't.
You didn't? Because
I get in trouble about that every day. Actually.
Every day.
I only got 12 credits left.
Oh, that's bad. Yeah.
It's time to finish that one.
But
yeah, eventually when I get around to
it. But right now you're busy being a good father.
Yeah.
A prolonged argument on this podcast is college really worth it?
No.
I say that. I finished college and I say
it depends on what your mindset. What you want to do with it. You know what I'm saying? Of course, you want to be a doctor or a lawyer, you have to go, but if I knew what I knew today, then I wouldn't be $60,000-$70,000 in debt for no reason. You know what I'm saying? If I had my degree, I still wouldn't be using it. It'd just be collecting dust.
And that's something we discussed earlier on the Father Son podcast.
I would encourage any young kid coming up to learn a trade, something that they can't take away from you, so you'll always be able to make money.
That's why I try to put a camera in someone's hand.
Yeah, camera, I wish I had that. A plumber, an electrician. A carpenter is all they make a lot of money. You know what I'm saying? You can make
good amount hourly.
Way more than what you're going coming out of school. If I went to school, business management. If I was coming out, I probably started $40,000 a year.
At least. Yeah.
Hey, but I just made that in one movie. You know what I'm saying? So it's like why waste that time? So basically they're paying you to forget your dreams.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? They're paying you to help somebody else build their dream.
That's what it is, right?
Yeah. So
once you working for someone, you investing in their goals.
I'm a really push the envelope for entrepreneurship to my daughter. Number one, she's gonna be set already. I'm gonna have stuff already set up for her that she's making residual money. Right. Like she won't have to. But I'm like, if you want to do it, you can. But you don't need to. You know what I'm saying? So that's gonna be a big thing. I just don't see the logic and working 30, 40 years for a company. All that. My dad worked SEPTA, so I'm sorry. My dad was working 14, 15-hour days. Mm. I never seen him.
But that was the era. That was the era we came up. Our parents pushed that.
Yeah.
I worked for the school district of Philadelphia.
Yeah,
so.
I never seen him. You know what I'm saying? When I seen him, he was asleep.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, what good did that really do? I'm saying, yeah, he had money. You ain't had time to spend the money because you was working. You know what I'm saying? So.
Right.
That's how I look at it, though. But this all the young people out, man, just look at trades, man. It's way less debt And there's way more income.
And there's way less time than
blocks.
Yeah. A man that says that who lays his own floors and stuff in his house. I've seen your work.
I mean, yeah, I learned
you did
it.
A good job, too. I got all this flooring sitting here, too.
No, I ain't working for nobody.
I know that. I know that, man.
I started for you. I can show you.
Yeah, I know how to tongue and groove, but I ain't got the time. I can't get down there.
Nah, you can find. You better put any young fellas at work. You, too. Yeah. Can I teach you?
Sure.
You know what I mean?
But
no, go ahead.
I was gonna say, all together, I think that like the mission, like you say, you had one goal left. Yeah. I don't think it's just one goal left. I think
that was off my list.
That was one goal off the list.
Now it's time to write a new list.
Yeah, from 2013.
So you're gonna write a new list, correct?
I was trying to wait time for my last.
Nah,
drink.
You gotta write it now, baby. You gotta write it now.
Because
listen, if you have five things down and you only got one left, you might as well write your next six.
Because
they might come before that one.
I ain't closed the deal yet.
It's coming though.
And when they do, I'm gonna write a whole nother list. Y'all gotta wait till I close the. I can't move on, man.
But y'all keep writing them lists, young people.
I'm just gonna keep working, man. Like. Regardless of a list or a goal list or whatever, I'm always going to work.
Oh, yeah. And you got other avenues coming your way you don't even see yet, I'm sure.
We'll see.
You know what I mean? I'm serious. You know, like, there's some things that are coming your way that aren't visible yet. But as an old head, I see them, like the paths that are traveling.
Yeah.
Even the circle that you're with, there's always going to be work for you.
I hope so.
There's always going to be a need for you. You know what I mean?
Hope so.
And I'm not talking about just doing weddings and reception, because you know,
I don't know, I'm kind of turned off about.
But you could
now.
But you could turn that into a movie too. Yeah. You know, but just the talent that you have and the vision, I suggest you young people. Period. Go check out Trap One. Go trap out Part Two
when it comes out.
Yeah.
And look at all his video work. It speaks for itself.
I got like 500 videos out there. So
yeah. Easy. Yeah. Easy.
Yeah. It was one year I was knocking 3-4 out a day.
And how did you find that to be like I noticed you're very particular about the scenes you put in. Like when we were down American Street, like that certain setting, you was looking for that certain.
Yeah, after a while you get an eye for it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if I was already blessed with it.
You blessed with eye for something, because we was out there from sun up to sundown.
I had a saying. I was like, I wish they see what I could see.
But nobody can walk in your shoe.
Nah,
you know,
you only can help guide them.
Yeah,
that's the only.
And nobody's gonna love what you do more than you do.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
For sure.
I wanted to make sure that the kids understand.
How did your parents feel when? You know, you was like, Mom, I want to make, and Dad, I'm going to make video movies. I'm going to make movies.
My dad didn't really say too much. My mom, she kind of was against it at first. My stepdaddy was definitely against it. I just, like, I'm the type of person, when I got my mind set on something, I don't care what nobody tell me.
Okay, and that's good.
Yeah.
That's good. Because a lot of times, I found out that, like, even I'm cautious of what I say.
Yeah.
Because I believe my son can accomplish any goal that he put his mind to, and that's just not blowing smoke up his ass. But a lot of people say that to their kids because we don't want nothing, but a lot of times we play safe with our children. I'm not going to tell him some things. My family would play safe with me. So the 9-to-5 I was taught to get, go here, make sure you get a house, make sure you get this.
Yeah,
you understand? But I'm not going to say that to him. I want him to do what you feel you can do. But you still need that 9-to-5 to get you through until this starts really getting to where you at.
Yeah, I kind of just did mine the whole opposite way.
You did?
Yeah, you want to say I quit my job. I didn't have no other source of money.
It had to work.
He was all in.
It had to work.
Yeah, I was literally, I was all in.
It had to work, or you'd been asked out.
I'd have been on the streets down K&A somewhere, you hear me? But no, I did it my own way, the whole way. I did it my own way. I did it. I didn't listen to anybody. I got a family. I got a wife, a daughter, and I bought a house. So I feel like I made the right decision. Even though when people told me not to do it, I did it.
You did it your way. So am I looking to see a Chop movie, a story about your life? About the way you did it?
Yeah, eventually.
Okay.
It's just not done.
Are you putting a book out too, or are you just doing a movie?
Nah, it'd probably just be a movie, but it's not done writing itself out yet.
No, but just chapters.
Yeah, we ain't even quarter way in yet.
Okay.
It's a lot more to go.
All right.
Got any more questions? You surprised me with questions, so I didn't know.
I'm just
I've been quiet for a little bit now, so I got you.
You got any more questions?
I was just going to have the biggest takeaways that I want the youngins and myself to take away. Be independent. Know your worth. Make sure your circle is tight, secure. Understanding that it's not going to always work out the way that you thought, but it's going to work out the way that God intended on.
Yeah, for sure.
And I feel like the best way to end this podcast out is with Freeway, What We Do, because it was 17 years this week that it came out.
That's love.
And all you do is put in work, I felt like.
Yeah, appreciate it.
And that's all you talk about on this podcast is just work, consistency.
I'm proud of y'all too, man. Proud of you young fellas, man.
Rest in peace, Kobe.
Good luck to you, sweet. Rest in peace, Kobe.
This shit for my kids, nigga.
There's no cap, bitch.
That's real shit.
Even though what we do is wrong,
we still hustle till the sun come up. Crack a 40 when the sun go down. It's a cold winter.